Hello YouTube, I'm Ashish from RotoNM YouTube channel and you are in the right place if you want to learn rotoscopy in best ways. Hit the subscribe button and the bell icon so you are the first to know when I upload anything new. In this video, I'll tell you about some basic settings before starting rotoscopy. So some basic settings inside of Silvert, what you have to do. Okay, so now let's open our Silvert. So here is our Silvert 7. So here you can see that I have used this footage in my previous videos. So now let's see what are the basic settings. Okay, so first when you open your Silvert and import your project and footage and everything, so your Silvert will look like this. So let's see what are the basic settings. Okay, so here in the previous videos I told you about some, I think, look, this thing. In my previous videos I showed you this outer edge and the hard edge, but in your Silvert you will not be able to see the proper outer edge and hard edge. You see the same thing here like this. The edge is totally blurry. Okay, so the first setting is make it pixel edge. Okay, so now to do that you just need to come to here, file, preferences, and just come here inside of viewer. Okay, so this is the viewer, and inside of viewer here you can see zoom filter. Okay, so make it nearest. So after doing this to nearest, just click here apply and then okay. So look, you can see all the pixel edges. Okay, so this is so important whenever you are doing roto. Okay, so the next setting is when you draw B spline, like this one is a B spline. When you draw anything, like if I draw here any portion, look here. So when I draw the shapes here, this green line is visible. So whenever I am going to edit all the points, this will disturb. Okay, this will disturb in editing. So what you need to do is just hide these green lines and these tangents also. So these are feather handles. Okay, so here you can give the feathers. So for now we don't need these feather handles, so we can hide these also. Okay, so how to hide the feather handles and this green bounding box, you need to just come here. Okay, inside of preferences. Now come here inside of preferences, and so this is the shape. So you'll find the setting inside of shape. So come here inside of shape, and the feather handle here is show feather handle. So this one is just remove the tick, and here show tangent vectors. So remove this tick also, then apply and okay. Now you can see that it will be easy to manage. Okay, when you draw any shapes, so while drawing the shapes you can still see the green bounding box, but after completing the shapes it will be hidden. Okay, so remember these settings. Another thing is the shape color, the default outline color. So whenever you create any shape, the shape outline color is red. So you can change this also. You can make it black default or blue default. So I'm making blue default. So to do that, just go to the same place, preferences, and here inside of shape, just see the outline color, default outline color. So here it is red. Okay, so just click on this and choose any color you want. You can pick a color from here also, and or you can choose just like clicking on this and then okay, and then apply. Okay, so now if you create any shape, then this will be the color you chose. So I chosen blue color, so now it's blue. If I want black color, then I can also choose default outline color to black. So now if I create shapes now, then it will be black. Okay, so now it's black. You can also change the color of shapes after creating. Okay, so what you need to do, just come to object list, select the shape. So this shape is this one. So here you can create click, right click, and then choose what color you want. Okay, right click, what color you want, or you can left click and then choose variety of colors. Okay, so this one. So I prefer black color only. Okay, so I always keep the outline splines black. Okay, and in some places like look like here, like this one. So if I click, choose black, then it will be less visible. Okay, so in such conditions, you can keep any highlighted color. Like if I choose white color, look, white color, then it will be more visible to the eyes. So you can adjust more easily. Okay, so like whenever you're drawing black hairs, or here, look, this one, this footage here, the t-shirt is totally red. So if the spline will be red, then it will be very hard to judge where the edge is. So I drawn like this, and the spline is red, then it will be very difficult to find the edge. Okay, so in these conditions you can use black, but here in the background there is black also, so we'll choose any other color here. So I think green will be more visible. Like this one is black, this one is red, so here green will be more visible, so you can choose it. But in such a condition like this or this, so here there are very less blacks. Okay, so here you can use black and this will be more visible. Okay, so this is done. Now let's see other settings. Come to preferences. Okay, and just come to viewer. So we chose this one. Okay, now here is, you can see the alpha overlay color. So what is alpha overlay color? I can show you. Look, I made some splines, and when I press shift plus A, this overlay color is blue. Okay, so if you want red or green according to your footage, look, if I have to make here, okay, so here the blue is more visible, so here you can choose blue. But if the background is just blue, then you will have to change the overlay color. Okay, so how to change that? Just come here and just inside viewer, click here, choose what color you want. Okay, so I chose red now. So now it's, the overlay color is red. And if you want to invert the overlay here inside of node, you can click invert, and then you can see like this also. Okay, so this is, so I mostly prefer this red color. Okay, you can choose blue or red or whatever you want. This depends only on your need. Okay, so the next setting, let's see. So let's come here inside of auto save, and you can choose at what intervals the file will be auto saved. Okay, so make it 5, that's okay. And the cache, so you can choose whatever you want, like and just make this total physical RAM to 90. Okay, so your silhouette will work very well. Okay, after that come inside of GPU. Okay, inside of GPU, and then here there is option of CPU, GPU and auto. Okay, so don't choose auto. If your computer has the GPU, then choose GPU. And if your computer does not have GPU, your computer have integrated graphics, then you can choose CPU. Okay, and if you don't have the GPU and you keep in auto, then it won't select the CPU automatically. What will do is when you do roto, in the middle of that your silhouette will be closed. Okay, so this will happen because of this. So here inside of GPU, if you have GPU, I have GPU, then I chose GPU. And if you don't have GPU, that is graphics card, then you can choose CPU. Okay, just come inside of output, just let it as it is. And roto rv sessions shape. So these were the basics settings. Okay, so after doing all these, now you can start working. Okay, okay. And if you use two screens in extended mode, then you can arrange your tabs on second screen. So how to do that, let's see. So first, what you need to do is just come to rotoscopy workspace. Okay, so how to do that, just come here, Windows workspace, and this one is roto. Okay, so you can click here or you can just directly press F2, so you will come in roto workspace. Now whatever you need on second screen, just pick it and drag it and drop it in the second screen. Okay, so let's do that. So I need object list on second screen, so I pick. Okay, I can arrange according to my need. Okay, you can arrange it according to your need. So this is timeline. So how I'll click on here and then like this. After that, I need a node. Okay, so this one node. I need object, so this one is object. And I need this tree also, so I'll keep it here like this. Okay, and I don't need these things. Okay, when we create our project, then we need these things, but while doing roto, we don't need these things. So we can cut these, cut, cut and cut, and this one also cut. So basically we need these 5 types only: object list, node, object, trees and timeline. Okay, so now here you can see all our tabs are on second screen and the viewer is on main screen. So if you're using a big screen and a small screen, then you can keep your viewer on the big screen and all the tools and tabs on the second small screen. Okay, so after that you can work very well. Okay, so here now you can see this is big screen and I can draw what how. So this is big screen, so I can clearly see everything and draw according to me and draw. So now I'm going to make a shape. So look here, shape making is also very easy now. Okay, so you can see now you can easily make any shapes, and while doing roto it will be so easy to work. Okay, and the another thing is you must be thinking that whenever we open our silhouette, so we will have to arrange these tabs again and again. So no need, what you can do is just save your custom workspace. So now I arrange everything. Now what I can do, just I'll come inside Windows and then workspace, and then here there is an option save workspace. So click on save workspace. Now here is level. So what name you want to assign this workspace? Okay, so I am assigning the name my roto C. I'm assigning this name, and here is the key. Okay, so you can assign any key. So I'll assign F9. Okay, for me it's F9. What you can assign F10 also. So for me it's F9. So I'm assigning it F9. Now my workspace is saved. Okay, so you can see here also my roto workspace. Okay, so if I press F2, then I'll come into default workspace, and if I press F9, then our saved workspace will come. Hey guys, if you find this video really helpful, then please give a thumbs up, and you can also support this channel. Here is Paytm QR code. You can scan it with your Paytm app, or you can directly send it to this number. Or if you are from outside of India, then you can use this PayPal link. I'll give this link in the description below.